Gary's Upton Base. I haven't seen you in a while. I'm sorry, we've been really busy since the ISB competition. It's been, what, since June, July? I don't think we've posted a video. I am here today with Harvey S., the one and only Harvey S. He's at the shop with us. He brought his base in for some tweaks. Lo and behold, he's actually taking a different base, my base. Very excited about that. If you don't know who Harvey S. is, you should check him out at...
www.harvies.com. There's no EY in Harvey. HarveyS.com. And come over to the website. There's a lot of good things there.
So, anyway, I just wanted to say hi. It's always exciting for us when we have a great, great player like Harvey here. We appreciate him greatly playing our bases. It does mean a lot to us. Everyone's got that ideal in their head that, you know, if you're a real jazz musician, you know, real New York City jazz musician, you know, smoky clubs and so on and so forth, you know, you must be playing an old Juzek or, you know, some old bass falling apart because that's got that sound. You know, our bass does that for you. I mean, I throw it at you.
Okay, well, I had been playing before I used your bass, two basses ago, I was using a Jacquet French bass, an old one. And it was a great bass, but it was so temperamental. It had a good sound, but it was very temperamental. Some days it sounded good. Some seasons it sounded good. Other seasons it was like pulling teeth, trying to get a sound.
Yeah.
And
that's the one with the buzz, you said?
Yeah, it had a buzz in it that would sometimes be there, sometimes go away. And I never quite found out what it was. And then I ended up going the extreme, and I used a plywood that was kind of completely rebuilt with all new everything. And it was a really beautiful sounding bass, but it didn't quite have the depth. Then I was at the ISB and I was thinking, I'm gonna come home with a bass in this one. And I really tried, you know, there was a lot of, that was like the, you know, the bass buffet. there were all kinds of basses and there was a lot of, you know, wonderful instruments. And I'm not gonna say they weren't, but I went over to the Upton basses and I ended up picking up the hybrid. I picked it up. I said, now this is feels like what I want a bass to feel like. The string length, the action, and the sound was really good. And it was a nice sounding bass. I used it on everything for the past couple of years, and it sounds great.
Yeah, some recent albums, right?
Yeah, it's on the new Westchester Jazz Orchestra CD, which is called Maiden Voyage Suite. And I've gotten a lot of comments about how good the bass sounds on that.
Well, and of course, it's just the bass, right?
It's not you. Not me.
And on a serious note, maybe we'll include this with the video, or maybe we won't. We don't pay people to like our basses.
If I don't like a bass, I'm not going to own
exactly.
it.
Exactly. And those are the kind of guys we like. Gary Carr, John Petitucci. You know, John uses our basses at school and teaching. Obviously, he doesn't play one. He's using the Martin bass, and he's selling the Vium. I know he's gotten rid of that, but he's playing the Martin right now. We love the Martin basses, too. But, you know, it's important to me to really hit that home to people that, you know, these guys, I'm sorry to say that, but guys like you, you're not getting paid to play our stuff. You know what I mean? And we appreciate that. We're honored that you actually approach us, like, at the ISB, and can I buy this? Like, well, really? Okay.
Yeah, because I hadn't even met you. In fact, I didn't meet you then because you weren't, I don't think you were there. Just Eric was there.
Yeah.
And we talked it's not like we're old friends and I didn't know you. I just said, this is the kind of bass I want to play. And then I got the bass. So, and I really enjoyed that bass, but I will say the one I'm getting is a little better.
I think it's 2 years later now? There's the ergonomics and the neck heel are huge for us. I'd say we've refined the tops. We've refined everything. How we carve the tops, how the necks go into the body, the taper of the ribs, the taper of the neck, even the shapes of the necks all the way through up to the nut. Anyhow.
Great.
We really appreciate it. We really do.
Thank you,
Gary. Appreciate you playing the basses. And we'll shut up.
Okay. I'm going to play my new bass, and so this will be the first time I really ever play this bass. So, no kidding. Thank you. like this bass.
Cool.